The most dangerous and advanced APTs are those that use a zero-day exploit or a specially crafted malware. A zero-day attack exploits a previously unknown vulnerability, and therefore there's no patch or fix for the vulnerable system, and most likely there's no prevention or detection signature for the attack. That is, a zero-day exploit will succeed and go undetected. Likewise, a specially crafted malware is usually designed to defeat the signatures and behavior patterns in a detection system. That is, it also has a very high chance to succeed and go undetected. APTs are characterized by its ability to not only evade anti-malware and network intrusion detection systems, but also fool even the most sophisticated users. For example, an APT can be designed to first compromise an internal network router or server, and all it does at that point is to learn about the valuable individuals. That is, the APT will first learn who's emailing to whom, on what topic, and with what kind of attachments in the email. With such knowledge, the APT can then forge email from a person to another, and this email can appear to be very legitimate. This is so-called spear phishing, because it is targeted to a specific individual. And if the internal network router or server has been compromised, the APT can play man in the middle to make such social engineering attacks very successful and very convincing. For example, if the email recipient is not certain about the email attachment, and he sends an email to the sender and asking, "Hey, did you send this?" The APT can play man in the middle to intercept such inquiry and send answer back to the user to say, "Yes, I sent this." APTs are also designed to blend in with normal activities to avoid detection, even if that means it has to go low and slow. For example, if an APT is designed to forge a document, it would not do so unless the user is also authoring another document. Similarly, if the APT is designed to send our document, it will not do so unless the user is also sending our document. As another example, if the APT is designed to change the setting of a controller in a nuclear plant, the APT does not make the changes all at once. Instead, it will make incremental small changes over time to accomplish the eventual attack goal. For example, the famous Stuxnet falls into this example, and you can search and learn more about it. And because APT activities are designed to blend in with normal activities and go low and slow, it is very hard for an anomaly detection system to catch an APT. APTs are often designed to stay in the compromised organization for a long time. For example, always looking for more valuable data to steal. For example, an APT can include a number of steps, and at each step, it only focuses on a subset of the users and only part of the network. And at each step, it may actually use a different version of the malware, and when it moves from one part of the network to another, it may clean itself from the old part. That is, at any given time, it's only present at the specific target. In other words, its footprint remains to be very small.